بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This question comes from دكتورة وسام. What is the definition and significance of delayed cord separation or delayed umbilical cord separation? Basically, the umbilical cord generally dries up and sloughs by 2 weeks after birth. So the definition of delayed cord separation, if delayed cord separation more than 3 weeks, this is the first definition. The second definition, persistence of cord beyond 3 days should prompt consideration of 3 things. Delayed cord separation, 3D. 3D indicate or the significant, it will be 3D. The first D actually, immune deficiency. Deficiency, immune deficiency, would call it neutrophil adhesion defect. Neutrophil adhesion defect, neutrophil functional defect, or migration abnormalities of the neutrophil or natural killer defect. This is the first considerations you have to put it in your mind if there is delayed cord separation. The second D, the factor 13 deficiency. Factor 13 deficiency. So the first one, immune deficiency, neutrophil adhesion defect. And the second D, it will be factor 13 deficiency. The third D, actually it will be duct abnormalities. Presence of persistent omphalomesenteric duct. Omphalomesenteric duct or patent urachus. What is this means? Resistant omphalomesenteric duct, because the vitelline duct, actually the duct it will be between the umbilical cord and mesentery, it will be patent omphalomesenteric duct. So the patient can be presented with intestinal obstruction, can be presented with abdominal distension, vomiting, and all of this. So the significance of delayed cord, the delayed cord separation, resistance, you have to think about resistance omphalomesenteric duct. There is duct between the umbilical cord and the mesentery, and the patient will be presented with abdominal distension or intestinal obstruction or patent urachus. What is the meaning of patent urachus? Urachus, this is the communications between the apex of the bladder and the umbilicus, between the apex of the bladder and the umbilicus. So the patient will be presented with UTI, or the urine can come from the umbilicus. The urine can come from the umbilicus. Why? Because patent urachus. Urachus, this is a communication between the apex of the bladder and the umbilical cord. So the urine, it will come from the bladder to the umbilical. So the patient, you will see the urines come from the umbilicus. You call it patent urachus. Patent urachus. This is the significant of delayed cord separation. 3D. The first D, immune deficiency, neutrophil adhesion defect or migration defect. The second D, factor 13 deficiency. And the last D, duct abnormalities. We call it resistance of omphalomesenteric duct. It will be duct between the umbilicus, the umbilicus, and mesenteric, it will be in the intestine. So we'll present with intestinal obstruction. Patent urachus, the urachus, the communication between the apex of the bladder and the umbilicus. And the patient can be presented with UTI or the urine to come from the umbilicus. For sure, you have to consult the surgeon in such cases, and you have to counsel the parents. ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا. سلام.